Hey, what's up? I'm Devin Dawson, and I'm from Orangevale, California. So I started playing music when I was 12 years old. I have a twin brother named Jacob, and we just kind of had a garage band for years through middle school and high school. Started out playing kind of like classic rock, Northern California, rootsy kind of rock. And through middle school and high school, it kind of got angstier and angstier and heavier and heavier. When I talk about inspirations, I always talk about the three Johns. First of all, Johnny Cash is a huge inspiration. As you can see, I'm obsessed with black, and I actually grew up like 3 minutes from Folsom Prison. Orangevale is like right outside. Secondly, hugely influenced by John Fogerty, and he was a singer of a band called CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival, and they're this like Northern California, rocky, rootsy, kind of soulful country kind of thing. And lastly, the last John would be John Mayer. I remember, I'm pretty sure it was my mom that showed me Neon for the first time. And for some reason, like, I was just fascinated by the way that he did everything himself. He did it all, and it just always just kind of cut right through to my heart. You know, there was a couple years while I was writing and I kind of started snowballing in the town, and a couple other people had started wanting to record my songs, and I started talking about getting a publishing deal. And around that time I did a mashup cover on YouTube with one of my really good friends, Louisa Wendorf, and we did a mashup of Blank Space and Style, and we just released it a couple days after Christmas, and somehow Taylor Swift saw it and tweeted it and Facebooked it and all that, and it just kind of went crazy and went viral. So the first song I wrote by myself, like as a solo artist, I don't remember what it sounds like, I don't remember the chords, I don't remember the melodies, but I remember it was called Solar Plexus. And the solar plexus is this part in your body that when you get the wind knocked out of you, that's what happens. It's that like part in your gut. And I was trying to like roundabout, like super complicatedly tell a girl that she took my breath away. One fun fact about me is I absolutely despise and hate chocolate. One thing that I want to accomplish in the next year is I'd really like to tour internationally. Like, I've been traveling and touring since I was 16, and I haven't had a whole lot of chance to go overseas. The biggest highlight in this last year, or just in my musical career, was I got to go on tour with Tim and Faith this summer, and I got to play my hometown. And I feel like as a musician, getting to play your hometown and play to this sold-out arena is just like one of the biggest check boxes on your bucket list. Put it all on me. Chocolate, it's just like, you know how some people don't like cilantro? Like when they taste cilantro, it tastes like soap to them because it's like the chemical like enzymes in their mouth or whatever, not to get scientific, but like I feel like maybe that's my relationship with chocolate.